Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Underwood Field here in Blairstown, New Jersey. Saturday's high school soccer matchup as the 3-4-3 Blair Academy Buccaneers take on the 11-0 Mercersburg Academy Blue Storm right here on the Strive Network. Good afternoon once again, everyone. Matt Nelson alongside Derek Raymond here with you on this mostly cloudy Saturday afternoon. Derek, Mercersburg Academy has been one of the most dangerous soccer teams in all of Pennsylvania, and they are loaded with talent all over their roster. It all starts with Senegal native David Coley and Brazilian Pedro Melo.
I mean, anytime you have a Brazilian on the field, it's dangerous. Soccer's in their blood. But also, like you said, the dominant David Coley, who's got just an absurd amount of goals. I think he has over 20 on the season so far. And let's not forget, the entire team has shut out, I think, all of their opponents in their 11-0 record right now. So looking to continue their dominance, and Blair looking to upset.
Yep, 7 of their wins have come in shutout form. And real quick, we're going to take a look at today's player spotlight. And it's going to be on Ian Pardue for Blair Academy. He's a senior, a vicious leader, as well as a tough competitor, as you'll see here in just a few moments as we are just about set to get underway. He facilitates the offense and sets up opportunities for teammates such as Nate Shue and Andrew Booth, and he is also a vital piece to this Blair offensive attack. His lone goal of the season came against Belvedere in Blair's first game of the season. We'll keep an eye out for him throughout today's broadcast. Real quick, let's take a look at our coach's corner, and it's on the head coach of the Blair Buccaneers, Matt Nall. The young man from Wesleyan College is in his second season as the head coach of the boys' varsity soccer team here at Blair. He is also an English teacher. Coach Nall was previously the head coach of the men's soccer team at the University of New England, where he led the Nor'easters to a Commonwealth Coast Conference tournament berth in 2011. He was also an assistant coach on the men's soccer team at Williams College in 2009 and helped lead them to a Northeastern Soccer Collegiate Athletic Conference Championship and a spot in the Final Four. Coach Nall has also played for the Morris County Colonels of the National Premier Soccer League and the New Jersey Rangers and the Portland Phoenix of the Professional Development League. So we are underway here in the first 40-minute session between Blair and Mercersburg. As we set our game clock here for this afternoon.
It's a nice early start by Blair to go in and try and pressure Mercersburg.
Having some small technical issues, so we will get them fixed as soon as possible. And there we have the scoreboard, so we are back up and running here in Blairstown, New Jersey. Again, it's Blair versus Mercersburg here in boys soccer right here in Blairstown, New Jersey. Blair Academy will move from left to right here in the first half, while Mercersburg will move from right to left. Blair in their home white uniforms with white shorts, white socks. Mercersburg in their blue uniforms, blue tops, blue shorts, and blue socks. There's a header by Blair, and that ball is kicked out of play, and now a save coming up for Blair Academy off the foot of Mike Yacano, Jr. from Switzerland. One of the few international prospects here on this Blair Academy team. Coming up on 2.5 minutes here in this first half, no score between Blair and Mercersburg. And here come the Bucks on the attack. Stephen Frick, lucky number 13 in white. trying to make his way on the attack as we have a little bit man on it. Two players go down, and a whistle has been blown. Number 8, Ukochukwu Okolo.
Yeah, Okoli, known for his speed. He almost beat out the last Blair defender there and tried to get a shoulder in front of him, but in doing so, took down both players, so that's going to be a goal kick every time, or a free kick every time, taken by the goalie.
The clouds have made their way here into Mercersburg. No chance of rain here. 65 degrees the temperature currently right now, and a bit of a moderate breeze in the air here in northwestern New Jersey.
Yeah, Blairstown's a beautiful place, and the campus is set, as you can see in the background, some rolling hills. That's a golf course back there, and as the trees change color, it's an awfully pretty campus as Blair looks to push forward.
Andrew Booth, number 14, he had his dribble intercepted by Ryan Claff, number 5 for Mercersburg. And we've actually been very busy here at Blair Academy over the course of this week. We covered a volleyball game against Pope John High School, as well as a girls' soccer game against Montclair Kimberly. So we're in the culmination game of Blair Academy Athletics here for the week of October 18th. So glad you could be with us here on the Strive Network. That ball hit high in the air, and now a whistle has been blown. And it'll be a Blair with the free kick coming up.
Nice defensive stand by Blair so far. They're able to contain the dangerous heads of the strikers here, because they do have some length to them, some tallness, if you will.
Okoli with the ball on the near side of the field. Defended well by Blair. There's a shot attempt deflected by the Bucks. There's another shot attempt.
That should be a handball as he went down, and it is. So they're going to call that. As he went down, he put a hand on it inadvertently, so they'll call that one.
And now they finally blow the whistle as Mike Yakana was about to punt it away for the Buccaneers. Just past 5 minutes here into this opening period, no score between Blair and Mercersburg. That ball is kicked away by Eric Tavares, number 6 for White, and we have a whistle, and Blair will have an upcoming free kick. Blair coming in 3-4-3 overall, and they are 1-4-3 since September 20th, which features a very exciting contest that you and I actually witnessed last weekend at the Hunt School, and a game that resulted in a 3-3 tie. There's a chance by Blair, and coming up with an aggressive save is the goalkeeper, Atticus Shore, for Mercersburg. That game that Derek, you and I saw last week against the Hunt School, an absolute thriller. A game that finished 3-3 after two overtime periods.
I know all the fans wanted to see an outcome other than a draw, but as the rules state, they get an overtime period. I think it was two overtime periods, and then they call it a day. So the light was subsiding, couldn't really see that much, so an exciting game nonetheless. We actually had some bonus coverage of that after the football game, which you can see again if you'd like to just go to YouTube and search for Blair Hunt football keywords, and you should find the stream.
And there's the first goal of the game by Mercersburg,
interrupted by classy passing and a great shot. Let's see if we can take another look here.
That was Pedro Mello who got the goal for the Blue Storm. That is his 14th goal of the season. And the Blue Storm jump out to a 1-0 lead with 13-33. Shoving between the two teams, and that ball kicked out of bounds. And we'll see who the throw-in is going to be on. It's going to be Mercersburg as Marincha quickly gets this one away.
Yeah, I like that out of Aiden Chu, standing his ground and not letting him body up. All of these movements and pushes for Blair right now are starting off really very nicely. They're able to make nice touches, but just at the very end, that last pass just isn't quite there for them, and that's what they need. They need to be able to finish these pushes forward.
Mello falls to the ground, and we have a whistle. One player went down as well for the Buccaneers, and it looks like Aiden Hsu was limping for a brief moment for the Buccaneers.
So we'll have a free kick just outside the goalie box here. Another excellent chance for Mercersburg.
Gustavo Farina will take the free kick. And it's deflected by a Buck defender and kicked out of bounds. Behind the Buccaneers again, so it'll be a kicked out of bounds by Mercersburg. So it'll be a Blair free kick coming up.
The wall did a good job there. It did its job. It blocked the direct kick.
Booth and Klaff going at it, and Klaff gets it away. Marincik finds Mello, and that one was kicked. Looked like it was off the face of Aiden Hsu. Hsu gets up with due time as Purdue headed to that one.
I think Shu's going to have a bloodied up nose right now.
And indeed he does. The whistle has been blown, and Aiden Hsu is going to come out of the game. Aiden Hsu got drilled right in the face, and now he's got blood coming out of his nose. And John Corio will come in to replace Aiden Hsu.
He's all right. Just got punched by a soccer ball. I think they'll clean him up, stop the bloody nose, and he'll get right back in there because he got up fine. You know, that it hurts. Hurts a lot. You know, playing soccer, I remember as a goalie, I've gotten knocked in the face a few times, and it's not fun.
Mercersburg again on the attack. Kicked to the other side and headed. And now an opportunity. Is it a goal? Yes, sir.
Again, it's going to be David Coley. And it seems like Mercersburg and Coley especially are able to just operate in these very tight spaces. As we take another look here on the replay, they're able to operate in very tight spaces with a lot of comfort. So see if we can slow it down here. I mean, he was just able to get free. And that's what you can't have if you're Blair Academy. You can't allow their best player to get free.
Now, penning the scoreboard here at Blair, that would be Coley's 23rd goal of the season and his second of the game. But the scoreboard has yet to be updated, so not sure if that goal counted or not.
I mean, it must have. They took a kickoff at midfield, right?
Yes.
So I'm going to go ahead and say that's an official goal, and scoring is just taking their time putting it up.
So it's 3-0 Mercersburg as we approach the 11-minute mark of this first half. And now Blair on the attack, and each shoe looking to find a teammate, but it's kicked away by Elliot Hicks. So we mentioned early on in the broadcast some of the notable alumni, Jack Taylor being one of them. How about the class of 1978, the owner of the Indianapolis Colts in Jim Irsay? that's certainly a huge name. If you went to Mercersburg back in the 70s. Also on this list, James Stewart from the class of 1928, one of the actors in It's a Wonderful Life, as that ball is kicked out of play. And we'll have our first corner kick of the contest.
You know who else graduated from Blair?
Who's that?
Charlie Villanueva.
Well, I was talking about Mercersburg.
Yeah, but I'm talking about Blair, baby.
The corner taken by John Corio, but it's knocked away by the Blue Storm. David Coley on the attack, doing that nifty footwork as he serves this one to Marinchik. Little one-on-one matchup. Ryan Claff. And that ball kicked away by Blair. A shot attempt that goes over the goal. That was Nathan Marinchik with the field goal. Had this been football. And Blair will have a goal kick coming up. There's actually a football game going on behind us as we speak, and Blair is already up 21-0 in the second quarter. With under 10 minutes to go. 8:40 to play here in this contest, and Mercersburg with a 3-0 lead. Powers on the far side.
You gotta clear that. If you're Blair and that thing comes whistling in,
oof,
you have to clear that. I know it was a miss hit and an error, but you know, with the talent that these guys, Mercersburg that is, has up front in a Coley and in David Coley, that you cannot afford any errors within your own 18. You just can't.
And a Coley just kicked that ball wide to the right of the goal post. So it'll be another goal kick coming up for Mike Yacano. Yacano bends it right toward Ryan Claff and right back into the hands of Yacano. Yacano punts this one away. A miss header. Another one. Little bicycle kick. Now we get a header by Powers. It's like volleyball going on right now. .7:15 to go in the game clock here in this first half, and Mercersburg with the 3-0 lead, looking to go to 12-0 on the season and 2-0 in the Maple League. Under 7 minutes to go. Another chance for Blair, but the ball quickly scooped up by Atticus Shore. Quick kick by Patrick Morrison. Booth kicks that one slowly out of bounds, right to a spectator. And Ryan Claff takes the quick throw in. Hit on the chest by Farina. Back to Claff. Doyle. Powers. Works it back to Shore. Shore quickly kicks this one just shy of midfield. .5:41 to go here in this first half. It's been all Mercersburg from the very beginning. As that one deflected by Nate Shu. And Powers lets that ball roll out of bounds. And Shore will take the goal kick. On the attack now, Blair. Looking for the first goal of the game, and that one deflected off the head of Athenas Linden.
So Blair will have an opportunity here with under 5 minutes remaining in the first half to get on the board.
So a corner kick coming up, and Corio will take it. Corio, it's it straight. Right toward the press box, and coming on to try and save it from going out of bounds is Hicks. Hicks gets it away to O'Coley. Check that. That's David Coley. .412 to go. First half. Hicks. Powers.
Yeah, that should be offsides. And it is.
And indeed it is. Offside call on Mercersburg. And Lamont gets the free kick away quickly. Nate Shu off the chest of a thing by Blair. And check that. Mikey Connor was actually still in the game, so I do apologize for that. Mello. O'Coley. Looking for Coley, and Coley's shot is wide and up the hill. Good attempt by David Coley, but not enough effort to get that ball in the goal. So Mercersburg holds on to a 4-0 lead here in this second half of play. And Blair doing all they can to try to come back. Yukondo gets this one right about at midfield. It's headed away by Hicks and kicked away by Purdue. Mello with the header. Adam Sohi. Number 18 for Blair, getting his first header of the contest. Corio. A give and go. Attended for Eric Tavares, and Tavares nearly stumbled and fell to the ground. David Coley the other way. Coley, one-on-one, trying to find O'Coley. That ball is kicked away by the Buccaneers defense. Coley, again. And that's good defense that time by J.T. Lamont. Under 37 minutes to go here in this second half of play. And we're going to have a corner kick coming up for Mercersburg. Mello will take the corner. Mello serves it high. And that ball is out of bounds as Powers was trying to save it from going out of play. You kind of have to take the goal kick. Headed away by Nate Shu. Shu to his left, now to a pass to his right intended for Sohi. For Sobe, excuse me. And that ball kicked out of bounds by the Buccaneers. Purdue, right in front of the press booth, kicks this one to Mercersburg. Athenas Linden to Mello. And now Sobe with the ball. kicked away by Purdue. Powers. Mello. He's got Hicks. Hicks bends it toward Coley, but it's headed away by Lamon. Attempt that time by Nathan Marinchik, and a diving save that time made by Mike Iacono. Iacono's going to throw it this time. Tries to get it to Farina. Mm-hmm. 35 minutes to play here in this second half, and Blair trying to recuperate from the opening half. They're down 4-0 to the undefeated Mercersburg Blue Storm. Purdue. O'Malley. Back to Purdue. Purdue gets this one away, headed by Powers. Sobey down the near sideline, intended for Will Kim. Kim's got a one-on-one matchup with Mercersburg with the ball. Note we have a whistle.
Yeah, kicked out of bounds, or dribbled out of bounds. It'll be Blair throwing here. And it looks like we're going to have a corner for Blair, which would hopefully result in a goal here to put themselves back in a position.
Blair with the corner. It's kicked away by Mercersburg. Back to Blair. And that ball is going to dribble out of bounds. We apologize for some technical difficulties. We're back on the air as we were trying to fix our scoreboard for just a brief moment. Mercersburg still on top. It's a 4-0 game in favor of the Blue Storm. Coming up on 31 minutes to go here in this second half of play. As the sun has peeked out of the clouds for a brief moment, we've had mostly cloudy skies throughout the afternoon here at Blair Academy. And Blair will have a corner kick coming up. Corio will take the corner from the far side of the field. Corio, it's headed away by Hicks. Aiden Hsu. Give and go for... Check that. That was Marinchik for Coey. And Coey had that pass picked up by Yakano. Matthias Linden kicks it away. Headed by the Bucks. That was JT Lamon.
Nice tackle to get possession here.
Nearly stumbling to the ground is Nate Hsu.
That's an awesome job by Nate Hsu to get some fancy footwork to allow for a corner kick. That's a really nice job by Nate.
And his brother Aiden will take the corner.
Aiden now wearing number 14 because of his bloodied up number 11 jersey.
That's funny because Andrew Booth actually wears number 14 on a regular basis.
Andrew Booth is now wearing number 17.
So now to make things even more complicated, RJ Stein's supposed to wear number 17, but he's now wearing...
He's not.
Ah.
RJ Stein is not in at the moment.
Okay. That clears a lot of things up right there. So again, Aiden Hsu now 14, Andrew Booth now 17, and no RJ Stein. A free kick for Mercersburg. Check that for Blair. Yakano gets it past midfield. Headed away by Farina. Coley. And that ball intercepted by Lamon. 28-16 to go in the game clock. It's a 4-0 Mercersburg advantage. And nearly stumbling to the ground that time, Pedro Mello, number 11. Lamon kicks it and falls to the ground, and we have a whistle. It'll be a free kick for Mercersburg. Check that, it'll be a throw-in. As Okule comes off the field. Ryan Claff takes the throw-in. Mello. That ball kicked toward the other side of the field, headed away by O'Malley. And O'Malley gets it away to Will Kim.
That's Purdue with the excellent defensive stop there, because Coley had a pretty much a wide open look if he could get by him.
Nate Hsu. And that ball over the goalpost and out of play. It'll be a goal kick coming up for Mercersburg, and we'll have a sub coming in for Blair. Coming into the contest is Aiden Hsu. Not sure who came out. And we have an offsides play. Offsides call.
It's either offsides or a handball. And I think it might have been a handball.
Purdue quickly gets it away. Sobey. Corio. Works it down the sideline. Intended for Frick. But it's picked up by Ryan Claff. Sobey. Double team coverage. Great job that time by Mercersburg. And it's booted away by Farina. Morrison to throw it in. Nate Shue did the footwork that time, but it's intercepted. And here come the Blue Storm. Coley. Coley to his right.
What a pass.
Hicks. Great defense by Ian Perdue. That ball eventually kicked, and last touch is going to go against Ian Perdue. Matt Athanas Linden with a short throw into Mello. Kicked out of bounds.
Again,
by the Bucks.
Matt with the throw.
Mello. Hicks. Here's Athanas Linden. Headed by Morrison. Hicks. Headed again by, that time it was Lamont.
That's a nice shoulder, not going to get called.
Down to the ground goes Corio.
Yeah.
Nate Shue. And it's headed by Powers. So we have 24 minutes to go on the game clock. The Blue Storm scoring all four of their goals in that opening half. One by Okuchukwu Okoli, two by David Coley, and one by Gustavo Farina. It's been all Mercersburg from that point on, and Blair has come up empty to try to put anything on the board here in half number two. O'Malley, Perdue, Powers, and now Athanas Linden. Coming to the ground, and a whistle was blown. That was Perdue falling to the ground, one of the two captains on the Buccaneers squad. Nate Shue has it deflected by Mercersburg. Good defense that time by Pedro Mello. Here's Coley. Coley works by a defender. Coley. Short pass intended for Mello. Hicks has it. Hicks with a quick move. And it goes to O'Malley. And now Nate Shue. Shue goes to Kim. Kim back to Shue. That ball intended for Corio. Another give-and-go chance. Ryan Claff comes to the ground, and it's scooped up quickly by Yacano. 22 minutes to go in the game clock. And Blair doing all they can to get back in this game. As the sun is bearing down on Blairstown, New Jersey. To our left, Coley, another opportunity. That ball kicked out of bounds. Looked like he tried to save it that time, but the referee calls for a goal kick. We also have several dark clouds throughout the area to our north. But we're not expecting any precipitation anytime soon. Yacano. Gets it shy of midfield, hip off the chest of Farina. Claff. And here come the Bucks. Kim trying to get away from several defenders, and we have a whistle. It'll be a free kick awarded to the Buccaneers, and Derek, they'll have another opportunity to get a goal on the board.
They need to show some kind of offensive life here. You know, anything at this point, just to be able to build off of something. You want to learn and get better every game. So now's a great opportunity for Blair to figure out a way to overcome this and get a goal. And now looks like a better time, probably one of their best chances.
Nate Shu will take the free kick. And gets to the blue wall of Mercersburg defenders. Shu kicks it over. He bends it like Beckham, and that ball is out of bounds. Shu with a good effort that time. But nothing doing for the Buccaneers. So the Blue Storm will have a goal kick. Shore will take it from the near side. A short kick headed away by Nate Shu. Kim. Good defense that time by Farina. Shu. Farina. Kicked away by Athenis Linden. And Purdue works it back to Iacono. Iacono gets this one past midfield. And a whistle has been blown. Under 19 minutes to go here in the second half. Mercersburg leads this game 4-0. Meanwhile, on the football field just behind us, Blair has a 31-0 lead over Mercersburg. With the third quarter starting very briefly. Free kick from Blair, headed away by Mercersburg. That was off of John Corio. Purdue. Lamon. Morrison works this ball out of bounds. And Mercersburg will have a free kick coming up. 18 minutes to go in the game clock. And Derek Blair is doing all they can, like we've said on and on, to try to put a goal on the board and try to work that ball into the Mercersburg zone.
And what you don't want is what you see there, and that's, you know, penalties out of frustration. Nate Shu obviously a little frustrated with how the day has gone, so in trying to get the ball, he uses, doing everything he can, uses excessive body language and pushing and shoving and, you know, shoulders a guy in the back, and, you know, you don't want to see that. It's part of the game, but you don't want to see that. Don't want to get anyone hurt here. Thankfully, his little brother, Aiden, came back in, and he's been performing very well.
We get a whistle and a free kick awarded to Mercersburg. Farina works it to the other side of the field for Hicks. O'Malley to Kim. And here's Sobey. Farina to Hicks, and now Coley. Coley breaks out of the double team, breaks away from their defender. Coley with a shot attempt. That one quickly scooped up.
And that didn't lead, because of that, it didn't really lead to many opportunities.
So Matt Nall has a lot of work to do for the Buccaneers staff as they dropped a 3-5-3 in the season and 0-1-1 in Maple League play. Mercersburg going to 2-0 in Maple League play, 12-0 overall. Next up for Blair, they're going to play host to Kittanning Regional High School Monday afternoon at 4:15. Next time we're going to be back here at Blair is going to be on November 5th for the state finals.
And that'll be an exciting matchup for sure, and definitely exciting against Kittatinny High School. I know that they're a good squad as well.
So, for Derek Raymond, I'm Matt Nelson. Thanks to our executive producer, Tom Manfilo, for putting this all together. We will see you next time right here on the Strive Network and getting the final score from Blair Academy. Mercersburg 5, Blair Academy 0. Have a good afternoon, everyone.